Hello students, I hope you all are in good health. So students, this is your biology teacher and today we are going to start a new chapter, that is respiration. In our previous video we have completed the chapter photosynthesis. So let us start now the chapter respiration. What is respiration? It is a process that will release energy. So, respiration is a biochemical process in which glucose is oxidized or broken down in the presence of oxygen to liberate energy. So, students, the respiration, it is a biochemical process. It means that this process is a chemical process which occurs in living organisms, and in this process the glucose, which is the food formed in plants, it is oxidized. Here oxidized means broken down in the presence of oxygen to liberate carbon dioxide and energy. The carbon dioxide which is released here, it is released as a waste product. So energy released during oxidation of food. Oxidation of food means the breakdown of food, and the food is glucose. It is stored in the cells as ATP. So, the energy which is released in this respiration process, it will be stored in the cells as ATP. The full form of ATP is adenosine triphosphate. We have studied in 6th class in chapter cell that ATP is known as energy currency of the cell. So the ATP molecules are used to carry out various life processes and we respire to release energy. Then here are basics of respiration. In this, the food, it is used as source of energy. The food in plants is glucose. It is used as a source of energy. Source of energy means the energy will be produced from the food, that is glucose, by the respiration process in which there is oxidation of this food, that is glucose. It means the food will be broken down in the presence of oxygen to release energy and carbon dioxide. The oxygen is needed for the oxidation of food. Oxidation of food means breakdown of food. For that, oxygen is needed. Energy is released as a result of oxidation of food and is trapped as ATP. So the energy which is released by this oxidation of food, it will be released and it will be stored in the form of ATP, that is known as adenosine triphosphate. Carbon dioxide and water are produced as end products. So carbon dioxide and water will be produced as end products of the respiration process. So students, now we will study the types of respiration. Now this division, that is the types of respiration, they are divided into two types on the basis whether oxygen is needed during respiration or not in the cells. So on that basis, respiration is of two types, aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. So aerobic respiration, in this there is the presence of oxygen for the oxidation of glucose, for the breakdown of glucose to release energy. However, in anaerobic respiration, this is a type of respiration in which the glucose, it is broken down without the use of oxygen, and the end products will be different as compared to the aerobic respiration. So let us see what is aerobic respiration. The breakdown of glucose into carbon dioxide and water inside the body cells by using oxygen to release energy. In this aerobic respiration, the glucose is broken down in the presence of oxygen and it will release carbon dioxide, water and energy, and complete oxidation of glucose takes place inside the mitochondria of cell. So first thing we have noticed here that in aerobic respiration, the glucose, it will be broken down in the presence of oxygen to carbon dioxide, water and energy. Plus there will be complete oxidation of glucose, means glucose will be completely broken down. And this process will take place in the mitochondria of cell. Mitochondria are the cell organelles which are also known as powerhouse of the cell. Then aerobes. Aerobes are those organisms that uses oxygen for respiration. Now let us study about anaerobic respiration. When glucose is broken down without the use of oxygen, it is called anaerobic respiration. In this, the breakdown of glucose is incomplete. It breaks down into ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide. It is completed in cell cytoplasm and mitochondria does not take part in it. So, in anaerobic respiration, here glucose is broken down in the absence of oxygen and it will give ethyl alcohol, carbon dioxide and energy. Plus this respiration, that is anaerobic respiration, it is completed in the cell cytoplasm and the mitochondria does not take part in this process. So let us see the differences between aerobic and anaerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration, it occurs in the presence of oxygen, and anaerobic respiration, it occurs in the absence of oxygen. Then in aerobic respiration, the glucose is oxidized completely, and in anaerobic respiration, glucose is oxidized incompletely. Then the carbon dioxide and water are formed as end products in aerobic respiration. However, in anaerobic respiration, ethyl alcohol in plant cells and carbon dioxide or lactic acid in animal cells, they are the end products of anaerobic respiration. In aerobic respiration, more energy is produced, but in anaerobic respiration, less energy is produced. Then aerobic respiration, it occurs in most of the plants and animals, but anaerobic respiration, it occurs in few organisms like yeast and some bacteria and parasitic flatworms. Aerobic respiration, here the mitochondria, they are needed, and in anaerobic respiration, mitochondria are not needed. So here is one paragraph. In this, it is written over here that in animals, right, in humans for examples, whenever we are doing any vigorous activities, muscular activities such as heavy exercise or fast running, then the oxygen supply in muscle cells remain unchanged, but the demand of oxygen increases. So in that case, the glucose, it will broken down anaerobically and it will give rise to lactic acid and energy. So students, whenever we are doing any heavy exercise or fast running, then the demand for oxygen in our body increases, but its supply is unchanged, its supply remains unchanged. So there will be shortage of oxygen in muscle cells. So in that case, the glucose, it is broken down anaerobically and it will give rise to lactic acid and energy. So that's all for today. Take care.